Okay, so it's time to start this session. So good afternoon, good evening, everyone. So thank you for this. Thank you for coming to this session. So the last session today. So we are from NTT DATA, system integrator company in Japan. So last autumn, so the last October, we had OpenStack Summit in Japan. So my home country, and I spent a very exciting time with you. So and I'm very happy to join again to the OpenStack Summit here in Austin. So as mentioned in some keynote sessions like Jonathan Mann, so now OpenStack is coming to the next stage to support diversity of IT systems which running on the OpenStack. So today I will share you our experience in our Swift project. So especially putting focus on the problem we faced. So I'll talk about our real use cases and how we try to integrate Swift to some customers, especially legacy system. And I'm happy if it can be some help to enhance the diversity of Swift and the Swift users on the Swift community. Okay, so let me start with the disclaimer of the presentation. So I think it's very normal one, conventional one. So in this presentation, so we will going to provide the knowledge gained from our system integration project using Swift. So we are going to share our experience of what we faced, of what we learned in our presentation, hoping this is a help to some people who is now planning to use Swift in their system. So before talking detailed content, so let me shortly introduce ourselves. So we three people are all platform engineers in NTT DATA. So I'm Takashi Kajinami. I've worked in the Swift and the OpenStack project in NTT DATA.
I'm Masaaki Nakagawa, OpenStack engineer at NTT DATA.
I'm Masahiro Ikeda. I worked for OpenStack Swift, Docker container, and IoT platform.
Okay, so as I talked in the beginning, so NTT DATA is one of the system integrator company in Japan. So we do not provide any service using OpenStack, but we provide IT systems for our customers and also develop some features which is required in our customers' use cases. So we three belongs to open source professional sector in NTT DATA. So working about something like cloud technology like OpenStack, Swift, Shiplock, and Docker, and so on. And on the other hand, we also working about the data processing technology like PostgreSQL, Hadoop, Spark, and blah, blah, blah. And we are especially, standing here, especially responsible for the cloud platform using OpenStack technologies and working to provide private cloud by OpenStack and cloud storage using OpenStack Swift. So that is the reason why we are going to talk about our Swift project. Okay, so here is the agenda for this presentation. So first, I will shortly explain what is Swift, and then the reason why we use Swift for our system integration. And then, so Masaaki and Masahiro explain what kind of problems we faced in our real Swift project, and introduce our approach in this project with some detailed information about the two real use cases. And finally, so I will summarize and share what we learned from these cases. Okay, so Swift. So I cannot see many, so light is so bright so that I cannot see many the face of you. But how many people know about Swift here? Yeah, I know you are very good. And how many people using Swift or now have provided a system using Swift? Okay, so let me explain shortly about Swift. So as you know, or you may not know, so OpenStack Swift is a part of OpenStack project, and especially storage project. And Swift realizes distributed object storage like something like Amazon S3. So object storage is a new style storage with different interface from the conventional block storage or file system. So particularly, so Swift provides RESTful API, and the clients can upload data into storage as put request and download data into from the storage as GET request over HTTP protocols. So this REST API works on HTTP protocol, and so Swift is often used at the archiving storage for the web contents like photo or video or backup data. So Swift has many, many good features, but I don't know, I don't have so much time today, so I'm going to explain some key, these three key features, so the durability and the scalability and the openness. So the first key feature of Swift is the durability. So Swift creates some copies of the data in the storage cluster. For example, three copies, it may create the three copies of data inside the cluster and distribute these copies over devices, nodes, racks, and data centers. So even if some parts of a Swift cluster fails, you can protect data from these failures, and you can also continue to access to all data with remaining copies. So in addition, so Swift automatically detects disk defeats and heals missing data copies and other devices working properly. And from Grizzly and Havana release, I think very long time has passed since this gets released. So Swift gets global cluster feature, so which enables a geographically distributed storage cluster over multiple data centers to realize disaster recovery. And we are going to talk about this topic, but the disaster recovery is one of the topics most interesting to especially Japanese customers after our experience of big disasters like earthquake, tsunami, and so on. And the second feature is the scalability. So Swift distributes data over multiple devices, as I talked before. And when you add new devices, it rebalances data to the new node. So we can enlarge capacity and improve performance of Swift cluster by adding new Swift nodes. And we can extend the storage from small capacity, like 10 terabytes, to huge capacity, like dozens of petabytes. So I know there are many people who is running the more than, but the dozens of petabytes Swift cluster. That in addition, so there are no limitations on the number of devices you can add. So we can extend Swift cluster very flexibly. So you can add capacity as much as you need, when you need, and you can adapt your storage to your, let's say, undictable market situation, your undictable business situation with effective cost. So the last one is the openness. So Swift is the open source, so which works on the Python framework, and you can derive it on the common commodity IE servers and Linux. So you do not need any special devices for Swift to run Swift, and you can select cost-effective hardware to construct huge storage. In addition, so you can flexibly mix up some types of services in a single cluster. So you can add latest hardware to existing cluster consist of old servers. So you can add latest servers when you extend, and on the other hand, you can remove old servers from your cluster when they get broken after their maintenance period. So you can keep your Swift cluster for a very, very long time, regardless of the maintenance period of servers, which causes some problems for the previous or conventional systems, with replacing old servers to new servers. Okay, so now I've explained about three key features of Swift. So Swift realizes a very durable and scalable storage and makes us free from any vendor lock-ins. Okay, so Swift is great. So Swift is the best solution to realize durable, scalable, and open storage platform. But in many projects, especially in our many of our projects, so we faced a difficulty when trying to integrate Swift to the system. So today we will show some example here. So this slide shows what often happens with us. So one day, so sales guy comes asking me, hey, our customers is now planning the replacement of their existing storage and looking for the way to save data, their data from disasters. Do you have any good solutions? So I will answer to him, okay, Swift is the best solution for that. So it has very excellent global cluster feature and realizes geographically replicated storage, as I mentioned. So then the sales guy is going to is asking, does it have NFS or iSCSI or something like file system interface? No, we do not have any file system like interfaces. So in many, many cases, our there are not so many customers who are going to replace whole of their system. So they are going to replace the storage, but they would like to keep their existing system. And such kind of existing applications does not support REST API, and they are very, very often require conventional file system interfaces. So this kind of interface problem often comes to us. So this interfaces problem is a very big problem for us. So Swift is a very, very good solution to realize disaster recovery or massive scalability, low operation cost, using a self-healing feature for disk failures. But however, as I mentioned, so many customers don't change their applications. They are existing, their applications running in their systems today at the same time. And these applications don't support the REST API in many cases. Okay, so we are going to show some cases about these interface problems. So we are going to explain two use cases. So Masaki and Masahiro is going to explain two detailed use cases in which we are tried to solve that interface problems.
Thank you, Takashi. I'm Masaaki Nakagawa. I'd like to introduce two use cases in this presentation. And first case, using Swift as backup storage of legacy backup server. And after me, Masahiro will explain another case. Okay, let's start. First case, using Swift as backup storage of legacy backup server. One day, a customer came to us to talk about new project, new project overview, upgrading backup system for a public agency. This system backups various size data. For example, user data, user virtual machine image, virtual machine host image. Supporting contract of backup storage of this system is being expired. So user want to change storage to Swift. This project's goal is changing backup storage device. User requirements, backup data size is from 100 terabyte to 1 petabyte. Next, backup data is stored from multi data centers. These data centers are located far away each other. Backup data should be stored redundantly. Backup storage should be placed in multi data center. In addition, a backup system uses proprietary backup software. And the user wants strongly required that backup software is kept to use. So we should not change anything without storage. From these requirements, we define some points for design. These are points from requirement. Backup data size is from 100 terabyte to 1 petabyte. This is scalable. Next, data is come from large data centers, and data centers are located far away each other. This reads large region. Next, backup data should be stored redundantly, and backup storage should be placed in large data center. This is a global cluster. We thought that these points are satisfied by Swift. So Swift is, we think Swift is good for this customer. Next, we have discussed Swift integrated system design. This figure shows that system design overview, which is satisfying design points. For convenience, this figure set two sides. User system, backup server, Swift proxy, and Swift storage is deployed each side. Backup server gets backup data from user system. Backup server put or get backup data to or from each proxy which deploys same site. Swift proxy is set affinity configuration to operate put or get data to same site Swift storage. And Swift storage is set region configuration each site individually. We thought that this design is enough for requirement. But unfortunately, this design was difficult to realize because of low compatibility of backup server and Swift. Backup server does not support Swift API, and this server requires the server-specific virtual tape device on block storage. To use Swift as backup storage, we have to mount Swift to local file system as block storage. Like this case, we often received RFP from customer that using Swift as backup storage of backup software, which does not ready for Swift. Use case of backup storage is Swift for Swift, but we have to give up to use Swift because by legacy backup software. To avoid such an unbearable give up, we should prepare something workaround. As workaround, we have experimentally tried to mount Swift to file system by using CloudFuse. I would like to introduce it. CloudFuse is OSS which enabled Swift to mount as block storage to file system. If you create, delete, update files, CloudFuse changes this operation to Swift API request. If you want to know about detail of CloudFuse, please refer to the website. In this case, we set CloudFuse like this figure. By this architecture, we succeeded to mount Swift and make backup server read mount point. So we try to backup process to get issue point of this architecture. We get two issues to proceed backup process. The first is fail initializing virtual tape device. Virtual tape device initializing process creates temporary file and rename it, but CloudFuse does not support rename operation. So to achieve this issue, we need to improve CloudFuse or choose other same component like CloudFuse or do workaround. In this time, we choose workaround, create virtual tape device at other location. and move it. The second is Swift does not support append object data. During backup process, backup server appends backup data to virtual tape device, but Swift does not support append operation. To achieve this, we use DLO plugin. We can apply DLO plugin to appending operation. By achieving these issues, we have gotten one pass to backup. But if using this architecture for commerce, we need to more detailed analyzing. Oh, summary of case one. A requirement, we would like to use Swift as backend storage of legacy backup system. Issues, backup software does not support Swift API. Second, backup software needs to locate virtual tape device on block storage device required. Attempt, mounting Swift to file system by using CloudFuse. Result, we have got to succeed pass of backup. Workaround to avoid feature of initializing virtual tape device and using DLO plugin to support append operation. That's all of case one. And next, case two.
Okay, second case is to use Swift as storage for file server. We are asked to renew file server which has access from users in geographically separated areas. There are three requirements. First, users store data in local storage without any overhead with replication. Second, all users can share same files. Third, supports file-based protocols to write various size of files. Let me show the details of requirements. First requirement is that users store data in local storage without any replication, without any overhead of replication to keep the latency of access low. Users are located geographically separated areas and users store in local storage. So storage needs to be located in geographically separated areas like this picture. But it is required that all users can share the same files. So it is needed to bundle local storages in one virtual storage. If there is one virtual storage, users can share same files. After a user in EU writes a file in local storage, it is replicated to all other storages, and users in North America can read the file. The third requirement is to support file-based protocols, such as NFS or SHIFS, to write various sizes of files. The reason why customer requested is to reuse the existing many legacy applications and to avoid high risk and high cost while developing new applications. To use storage as backend of file server, accessing small files in low latency is required. These are the customer's requirements. From these requirements, we compared three storage software. First row expresses requirements. The second row expresses features to realize requirements. Third to fifth rows are the name of compilation of software. We chose Ceph, GlasterFS, and Swift, which have global cluster feature. This table shows Swift fulfills most requirements. Additionally, since we have knowledge of Swift, we plan to use Swift. But Swift has two issues for requirements. First issue is about file system interface. All those users need to access by file-based protocols such as SHIFS and NFS. Swift supports only REST API. Second issue is about small file optimization. To use as file server, accessing small files in low latency is required. But Swift is not good at processing many small files, because Swift is not optimized for small files. So how to solve the issues? This table shows issues and solutions. Second row of the table shows our solutions. We solved first issue to integrate cloud storage gateway. We solved second issue to add two features, data management with small block size and storage cache. First solution about file system interface is to integrate cloud storage gateway. This is a gateway software which translates good cloud storage APIs such as REST API and standard file-based protocols. Then users access to the cloud storage gateway by shifts or NFS. The cloud storage gateway transforms users' requests to REST API requests. After Swift responds the request, the cloud storage gateway transforms response of REST API to shifts or NFS response. Users can access the data in Swift by file-based protocols. This is a solution for file system interface issue. The second solution about small file optimization and data management with small block size and storage cache. Most cloud storage gateway has these two features. First is the feature which manages data with small block size. So the latency to access many small files randomly is optimized. Second is storage cache, which stores data which users are accessed. If cloud storage gateway has the file user accesses in storage cache already, it returns the file to the user directory. Since there is no access to Swift, the latency is very low. So does combination of Swift and Cloud Storage Gateway suit the requirements? Although Cloud Storage Gateway solved the two issues, it is important to confirm if Cloud Storage Gateway has the future of clustering, because this future depends Cloud Storage Gateway. If a cloud storage gateway doesn't support the clustering feature, it distinguishes the benefit of global cluster, which all users share same files. We used Phobos cloud storage cache, which is one of cloud storage gateway. It's proprietary software. This has many features. Of course, it has the features, data management with small block size and storage cache. Another notable feature is loosely cluster. Loosely cluster is a feature to bundle file systems of Phobos cloud storage cache with virtual one file system, which enables to share same files in multiple locations in cloud storage gateway layer. Phobos cloud storage cache in multiple locations replicate metadata respectively, so a user in North America can read the file which a user in Europe creates. Since Phobos cloud storage cache has clustering feature, the combination of Swift and Phobos cloud storage cache can realize every requirement. So we use it. This is a simple architecture. Each location has Swift and Phobos cloud storage cache. Since they are clustered and replicate data, all users can share same files. We did performance test. The table shows the result of comparing with the performance of ordinary file server. I'm sorry that I can't share specific performance. We got the result that the performance is enough good for file server when the protocol is NFS. When the protocol is shifts, the performance is not so good. But we can use it as file server, which that performance is not high priority. I want to share three limitations to leverage the solution. First is that the performance of Swift protocol isn't so good. I think the result is that the performance is not so tuned so far, since cloud storage gateway developers tend to focus on flexibility, scalability, and availability. As cloud storage gateway software market becomes matured, this problem would be solved. Second is that the performance becomes much worse when data is not on cache. Of course, the reason is that the latency increases by that of Swift, because cloud storage gateway gets data from Swift. It is important to design size of storage cache carefully. It is a key that to compare performance and cost efficiency while thinking the tendency of data usage. Third is that there is a good and bad point of integration. The good point is that we can get software-specific features such as global cluster. The bad point is that the availability becomes lower because possible failure increases while the number of components are increasing. At last, let me suggest an idea. The market size of cloud storage gateway is increasing rapidly. The market size would increase almost 8,000% by this year if compared to the level of 6 years ago. So I think the demand of the combination of Swift and cloud storage gateway is increasing too. Although proprietary software has many useful features, it is not optimized for Swift. How about developing cloud storage gateway optimized for Swift? In my opinion, there is a certain demand. Summary of second use case. This case is integrating Swift as backend storage of file server, which has access from users in geographically separated areas. Because Swift doesn't support file-based protocols and is not good at processing small files in low latency, we join together Swift and Cloud Storage Gateway to realize requirements. The performance is enough good for file server. Since Swift is superior to other software in global cluster future, to realize file server, which has the future, Swift and Cloud Storage Gateway is a very good combination.
Okay, thanks, Masahiro. So so these two guys explained about the real use cases and how we solve the problem we face there. So I'm going to summarize shortly what we learned from these two real use cases. So in the case one, we use the storage Swift at the storage of the existing backup solutions. In the case two, we used Swift at the backend storage of the file sharing service. So both of the cases we use is something like a cloud gateway, so for the interface transition. So in case one, we used CloudFuse to convert REST API to something like a Fuse, so Linux file system interface. And in the case two, we used a kind of proprietary software to convert REST API to the conventional SIFS NFS, so file sharing interface. So as a result of some projects, so we started to think about the cloud storage is very good starting point to integrate Swift into your existing systems. But of course, as Masahiro mentioned, so it often put a limitation. So such kind of a cloud gateway, it put a limitation on the benefit of given by Swift. For example, so we put more layers on the top of the Swift, so the number of possible failure points is going to bigger and bigger. And also, on the so we are now trying to use conventional application, but on the other hand, if we can use cloud native application, we can get all benefits of the Swift, just existing reality into this solution. So our future vision. So yeah, I think the cloud storage is very good starting point, but of course we know the. That is not totally ideal point, but I think so. We think what is the most important is to defining and sharing some successful something like a migration stories from the conventional software with conventional storage to cloud native applications and Swift, something like a new cloud technologies. So, for example, so we should share about I think it's better to share the starting points so we can start with something like cloud storage solutions to integrate Swift to existing applications. And we also should write some migration path to our ideal goal, so something like a cloud native solution. So, for example, for the backup solution there, some backup solutions which can natively support Swift. So at least, so we can bring, at the first point, that we can bring some of the benefit of the cloud technologies, and in the future, we can get all benefits of the cloud technology after migrating to the totally cloud native applications. And in addition, so as Masahiro mentioned, so we think that there are possible improvement about the cloud storage gateway, and we think the cloud storage gateway is very useful at the starting point of this kind of migration. So now we are trying to some possible improvement about stability and usability, and there are some other for the technologies in the conventional interfaces like NFS, SIFS, to improve the scalability or availability. So I think we can integrate them to realize more and more efficient system using cloud technologies. Okay, that's all for our presentation. So I think we have some minutes still. So are there any questions? I think many people are looking forward to go to the party.
thank you for the great presentation. So just a question. So you are describe the customer doesn't want make doesn't want to change their application at the same time, but so you can provide you provided the solution to integrate no without application change with this. Yeah. So in the story, I thought that is a midway of the integration. So I don't know what the actual customer requirement. But I wonder if in this way, we can migrate whole application into the Swift native after this migration ended.
Yeah, you're right. So, for example, in the backup example, so we can, at the next step, we will replace the existing backup software to the new backup software which can support Swift natively. For example, Amanda has some support of the cloud storage interface to at the backend storage. And I think in the second example, the file sharing example, so they are not using the SIFS or NFS or something like conventional file sharing interface. But I think there are other ways to realize file sharing, so something like a Dropbox-like interface. So we do not have to access to the Swift, but we can add some replication from the we can put some replication between the our local machine to the cloud. So and in that, so now on cloud or some other so Dropbox like softwares can natively support Swift. I think that the possible second step, so or the last step to the total, yeah. Totally cloud native system.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to hear the successful story yeah. for that. Thank you.
Is there any other question?
You said that to simulate the append operation, you need to enable DLO. Was this an option in Cloud Fuse, or did you have to write something extra yourself to get that in?
I think we created a special middle view to intercept the request to create the, so intercept the request of the creating a new big object to the creating facilitate the split to the segment and create a DL. So we added a new middleware to do it automatically because it is not so,
not so easy
yeah. to change the existing backup software. So we do it inside the Swift.
Honestly. Okay, so it's in Swift and not in the mounting of the file system.
So, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
So
cool.
I will ask my manager.
hi, a quick one. You showed that you actually have multi-cache, you have NFS running between two cache, US and Europe, and at the same time at the back end you have Swift. I wanted to know how you handle, let's say, if there are simultaneous access from NFS at both these sites, or let's say SMB, how does that play in?
Yeah, so yeah, very good question. So the, when we put the cache into in the multi-site, so the collision of the update is very big problem. So in this case, we are the we use this cloud storage gateways feature. So it can it has for the detection feature of the collision updating collision. So we can it. Raises alert when detecting that collision, and honestly speaking, we can fix it manually after detecting that alarm.
Okay, so basically, then eventually the last person wins, kind of a theory.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Right.
Is there any security issue facing all the kind of the how to say access rights or something like that?
Yeah.
No. So yeah, I think that depends on the cloud storage gateway, and this cloud storage gateway has some, let's say, the control about has enough access control to, so it manages the it can manage the the accessibility of the data. So they are also problem in these cases. Yeah. But of course, there are not so many. There are other. For example, the CloudFuse does not deal with that kind of access control. Yeah, that depends on the software you use. Yeah. I think time is over. So if you have another question, please come to us. Yeah.